5 things you should totally check before you go into production with your short film. What's up, guys and girls? Mike here, and I just finished my short film. So this will be a little case study to prevent you from the storytelling mistakes I've made in my short film. So if you want to see the short film before I spoil it, you can now click the info box right up here, I think. And for those of you who don't want to watch it now, I sum it up very quickly so you have an idea what I'm talking about. The movie is about a girl who gets triggered by an old woman in a flower shop because she says something like, "I won't let them die," and she's talking about the flowers, but it rings a bell on the protagonist Nelia. Then some strange things happen and our protagonist Nelia gets haunted by a little girl with a birdie leather mask who, how she later finds out, is actually her twin sister who committed suicide when she was 10 because she couldn't handle the early death of their mother. But at the same time, when Nelia remembers, she's also already dead because she also committed suicide because she couldn't handle all that stuff. That actually sounds like I had a very troubled childhood, but I had not. So, number one, don't just let random things happen to your protagonist. Everything that happens needs to serve a purpose. It has to develop your character or your story. The flashbacks and the strange things happening to my protagonist actually serves no purpose, just raising questions. So you don't get a lot of tension there, and the things happen and then she takes a warm, cozy bath. Rule number two, build tension. Nelia drives home from work and she thinks she ran over a girl, then her car is full of blood, and then she calls the police and then she takes a bath. Sounds like quite a good thriller, doesn't it? Okay, but now imagine that she lives with her dad and her dad is very clingy, so she needs money to move out with her boyfriend. And now imagine she has a very important job interview in the evening, and if she gets the job, all her problems would be solved. But now all those strange things happen that keep her away from her goal. We have goals, we have tension, we have pressure, we have obstacles, we have a story suddenly. Point 3. Make the audience invest in your character. Nelia is in the flower shop and she gets triggered and strange things happen. Why should we care? The character isn't likable yet and we can't identify with her. We didn't have a moment where we thought, oh, this poor thing, or I've also experienced that, or oh, she's smart, she's cool, I want her to get out of this situation alive. A short funny moment or a smart thing she says could have made the whole difference here. But I missed that. Number 4, a huge red flag, never tell the audience things they already know. Because it grows under the surface like a virus. Believe me, I took 60% of all the cheesy lines out, but I left this one in because I was afraid that the audience wouldn't understand what's going on. Which is, looking back, kind of stupid, because the audience just watched 5 minutes of strange things happening and getting out of control mixed with flashbacks and all the stuff, and then somebody comes and says, because it's so strange and it grows and it's blah blah blah, I don't know. Point 5, don't lack a theme. If you don't know what a theme is, you should totally check out Brian McDonald's book Invisible Ink. It really changes your look on story. But to give you a short insight, the theme is the heart of your movie. It's the one sentence that you can break every movie down to. So very often it's about philosophical questions like what makes us human human, like discussed in Blade Runner, for example, or even just some wisdom to get through life. It really helps to keep in mind what your story is really about and to really follow a red line. I will probably make a video about that in the future, but I want to first develop my own themes and work with them before I talk about it, so I won't go into detail with that. However, back to my movie, it has no theme. There's nothing you can learn about it, there's nothing that you can discuss about, it's just trivial. But it doesn't matter, because it's not like I've worked 2 years on this short film and... Okay, after looking at these 5 tips, it should be clear my movie sucks. But it was still very worth doing it. And you know why? Because I've made these mistakes and it's very important to make those, because I will learn from them and my next short film just can be better. And besides that, I've met a lot of interesting people and we had very much fun together. It was a great project and I also got 2 or 3 commissions from that short film. So even if it sucks, it's totally fine. Don't be too harsh to yourself. You will get better and better until you have success with your short films and you are able to touch the audience. Just keep up the good work. So, if some of those tips were helpful, you can leave a comment. I would really love to hear what exactly was great advice for you. You can for sure leave a like or subscribe if you want or not. Feel free to do whatever you want. And yes, that's it with this video. Hope you enjoyed it and see you next time. Filmmaking Boys and Girls, Mike out. Oh, it's the link to my short film. How did that appear here? I don't know, but it's with English subtitles. You can watch it. I would really love some feedback from you guys.